Hi guys! So Valentine's Day is coming up and you guys know I always do a bunch of videos around Valentine's Day. I actually love the holiday. It's fun. And I do like to give like small Valentine's Day gifts and things like that. I do feel, however, this year gifting is going to be a little different because of COVID and, you know, lockdown and all of those things. So here are the perfect Valentine's Day gifts for 2021. Category appliances, something like I would have never said 2 years ago. Like if you ask me, like, is an appliance a good gift? I'd be like, nah, it's so boring. There's no romance. Where's the romance in an appliance? It's just to like get calmed down and all. But right now, my friends, a dishwasher with some French music sounds romantic. Mon Dieu. So yeah, I mean, I feel like in the lockdown and over the last 1 year, everybody's been doing a lot of extra housework that we don't normally do. And there are some appliances that can really make your life easier. And I think romance is all about that right now. So I would definitely recommend a vacuum cleaner. A good vacuum cleaner really, really helps. I would recommend the Dyson. I've used it for a year now. Over a year, but the last year, like aggressively used it. And I love it. And I feel like it's life changing for a person that has to clean. A mop, a cheaper version, like if you want like something cheap that's not very expensive but like also helps clean those mops that I have. I don't know why I'm doing the mop dance, but you know what I mean, like where it goes down and becomes like the spin mop. It's called a spin mop. That's a great gift as well right now. Like imagine a spin mop for Valentine's Day, but it really makes your life easier, guys. Or whatever, you know, like whether it's a dishwasher, like I mean imagine like bartans right now, I'd be like, yes man, a dishwasher, that is like romance. So I feel like the appliances will give you time for romance, because in the last 1 year nobody's had any time for romance, because we are like doing like housework and then like work and then yeah. So an appliance is a good option. It's a romantic option this year. Then we have skincare and grooming. Again, through 2020, pretty much most people haven't visited a salon or done like excessive skin treatments and things like that. So I feel like a high-end cream, serum, face mask, all of those things are really good to pamper your partner. So if you know your partner's been dying to try like a good serum, get them ANR, the Advanced Night Repair Serum from Estee Lauder, the L'Occitane Serum, or you know, a really nice face mask set, stuff like that to pamper them at home. The other option that's really great is like grooming supplies, right? So for my dad, I bought him a trimmer, which is amazing for men. And I think it changed his whole grooming game in the lockdown. So yeah, men can't go get their beards groomed and all of that, so it's just easier and they can do more stuff with it. So that's a good gift. Or even like the Philips straightener brush that I used, like what was it, in one of our videos earlier, something like that, because like people can't go out and get their hair done all the time. So whatever makes them feel better, pampers them a little at home, get that. Then we have virtual sessions, okay? Pretty much everything is available online right now. Like you can do any class virtually, which is quite amazing, right? Like you can do fitness stuff, art stuff, like learn a language, absolutely anything that interests you. So I would recommend maybe gifting some virtual sessions to the person, because these things really help. You know, as I said, we're so absorbed in like this whole housework and work situation that there's no real me time. It's only when you take out that time and do something else and you realize, oh my God, wow, this is beautiful. I wish I did this more, whether it's, you know, art and craft, or whether it's poetry, whether it's fitness, whatever. So whatever interests them, maybe give them a few sessions of that, just to kind of break away from the monotony of our lockdown lives. Then we have my favorite, adopt a pet. Okay, so I'm not just saying this because I adopted Mars, but I feel like it's the best time to adopt, because a lot of us are spending time home at like home still for a while, and they will really, really change your lives. And this is a great gift to someone that you've discussed this with, right? Like, so don't just bring a puppy or a kitten onto someone who you've not discussed adopting with before. Only people who have thought of it and want to do it or stuff like that, for them, it's a great option. Like this has always been like my dream gift, you know, like you see these videos of people crying and the puppies being given to them as a surprise. And they're like, oh, this is mine. Yeah, that would have been me totally. I've always waited for that, for someone to give me a dog, but nobody ever gives me a dog. So I just went and adopted my own. It's a great, great gift for someone that you know, wants this. So as a family also, so many families, like in the lockdown, I think, through our adoption posts, we've had so many kids and families with kids that have adopted like puppies and stuff and sent me pictures, and they are so wholesome. So yeah, totally, if you guys have been like wanting to adopt a cat or a dog, now's the time to do it. And if you're looking for cats, my friends, I have three. So Vaibhav has been fostering three kittens, as you know. One of them is hopefully getting adopted this weekend. We still have two more for you. So yeah, adopt. The next one is masks. Obviously, right now, everybody is still wearing masks, and I feel like you can never have enough masks. Like this weekend, I have to go to a wedding, and I was thinking my usual black mask is really going to kill the vibe of my outfit. What should I do? Should I get another mask? You know, things like that. So you get a lot of these matching masks with your outfits. You get a lot of different colored masks. So you can get like a pack of masks, you know, which is a good gift, which will be used for sure right now. Or like a really good quality mask for someone that's going out to work every day and like they need the protection, or a comfortable, good quality mask, things like that. So I feel like masks are a very usable gift right now. Like, you know they're going to use it, and you know it's going to help them, keep them safe, which is what love is all about, right? Like keeping your loved one safe. So I think it's a sweet gift, a thoughtful gift. Next up, we have my usual favorite, food hampers. Okay, so I'm a big, big fan of food hampers. I advocate that food is the best gift a lot of times, because I feel like, especially for people that you're close, you know what they like, and you can curate a basket with things that they love. And it's a really sweet surprise. Like, you just get all of their favorite foods, put them in a basket, and like gift them to them. And right now we're all home, we're all eating. Like, I think in the last year I've spent the most money on food. So yeah, I would be happy to get a food hamper and save some money. And you can do it to the taste of that person. So right now, because you guys know I'm obsessed with Korea and all things Korean, I would love a Korean hamper. So like, imagine a basket, then you add some ramyun to that, you add some shrimp chips to that, you add some kimchi to that, some soju, put a ribbon on it, put a note on it. That's a great hamper, my friends. Home decor, plants, and local crafts. Okay, so this is a very broad category, but what I mean by this is there are so many, local stores that could use your help right now. And I feel like it's a great time to buy art or local crafts, because you're supporting the community, and it's also something that adds value to your home, because right now we're all sitting at home and we want our homes to look beautiful, right? And this is something you go forward with, like you want your home to be beautiful. So even it's like, if it's simple things, like for example, just the cushions on your bed, like look at this beauty. This is from AA Living. Like if you gift, you know, your loved one a nice cushion that's on your bed every day that you look at and you feel good, that's a great option. Plants always make you feel amazing. Like, as I said, if you're not stepping out a lot and you're in your house, but you have a lot of plants, a lot of greenery around you, you're going to feel like you're outdoors, but indoors, you know. Plants are happy. Plants make you happy. I don't think there's anyone who's been unhappy with plants around them. You know what I mean? So plants are always a great gift. Or even like a work from home station, if they don't have like a dedicated workspace, you can curate like a space with, you know, putting a desk and a plant and some stuff for them, and make an actual like, you know, work from home station for them, which I think is really thoughtful, really cute. And buy, like, as I said, local arts and crafts. So for example, I'd say like the Lacuna studio booby mug I have, like that would be a really lovely gift. You know, it's thoughtful, it's unique, it's helping a local business, stuff like that. Then we have subscriptions, okay? Subscriptions of all kinds. Netflix, Hotstar, Amazon Prime, Spotify, Storytel, Apple, whatever floats your boat, guys. So you know your partner best, whatever they're interested in. Now is a great time to give them a subscription, because they're sitting at home a lot of the time. They want to watch stuff, they want to consume stuff online. And honestly, I don't think I would have made it through the last 12 months if it wasn't for all my subscriptions. You guys know how much I have watched online, listening to music, you know, things like that. It's a really great feeling to have a bunch of subscriptions, and it really makes your life more fulfilling because you can watch a lot of junk online and feel good. So yeah, I think it's a very thoughtful gift because it'll be used for sure. Like, I don't know anyone that doesn't want to use their Netflix subscription, right? And I think the best thing is you can add it to whatever they have. So like, if the person already has like 4 months, you can give them 6 months and it'll get added to that. So it'll never go to waste. Then last but not the least, we have planners, organizers, and stationery. So I feel like right now our lives are in a place where, you know, everybody wants to write down things because we're managing our homes plus our work plus everything. There's a zillion things going on, but you're still like, you know, you have to organize everything and everybody's making a lot of notes. So it's really nice to have nice stationery around to make notes. So I always have like my diaries. I have one here, another one here. Never, you know, without my notes and like notebooks and things like that. So great stationery, I feel, is appreciated by everyone. So maybe like cute to-do lists, a planner. It's also great to buy a planner because we're still in the beginning of the year. So if your partner doesn't have a nice daily planner, get them a nice daily planner. Yeah, all that is really thoughtful and it's really helpful. So guys, those were my top recommendations for Valentine's Day gifts given the situation we're all in this year. I'm not obviously talking to people that are loaded beyond belief. This video is not for you because you can have all this and the diamonds and the designer clothes and the jewelry. But I feel like this is more for people who want to be a little more mindful this year and, you know, even if they have the money, don't really want to spend it on just material stuff that doesn't really help. Be thoughtful, be mindful, and do something for your partner that's really going to help them because everybody's had a tough year, and show them that you love them. So guys, I hope you liked the video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Also comment below with your recommendations for Valentine's Day this year. Let's see what you guys are buying your partners. See you guys. Bye.